Hi guys, my name is Ashley and I'm a mom of two little girls. I have a two-year-old toddler named Kylie and an almost five-month-old baby named Mia who is currently nursing right now. So if you see her little hand popping into the frame, that's who it is. So a very commonly requested video by you guys is a list of books that I recommend for children for a Montessori home. So for those of you who are new to Montessori, you might not realize that in a Montessori environment, fantasy is actually discouraged for children under the age of six. Children under the age of six have a very hard time distinguishing between fantasy and reality. This is often the reason why little kids are afraid of the boogeyman in their closet or monsters under their beds. So in the spirit of sticking to true Montessori philosophies, the books that I'm going to share with you today are strictly nonfiction books. With that said, I'm sure that some people automatically equate nonfiction with boring, and that is absolutely not the case. There's a huge selection out there of beautifully illustrated or photographed nonfiction books specifically designed for children. And because I do go to the library every single week with my daughter, I've had a chance to really kind of scope through some of the options that are available. So from one busy parent to another, today I am really excited to share with you my recommendation for nonfiction children's books that are perfect for a Montessori home. Okay, so real quick before I jump into this list, I know there are going to be a lot of you guys out there who are wondering what the appropriate age range is for some of these books. And honestly, I'm kind of hesitant to assign an age to each of the books that I'm about to share with you because all children are different. Their language skills are developing at totally unique paces, and of course, their interests are totally different from one child to the next. So I'm really going to urge you as a parent to just kind of use your best judgment based on what you see your child gravitating toward, what you think might be appropriate for him or her. Also, these books are not in any particular order. I just have them on a list on my phone, so I will be sharing them with you guys as I go down the list. Now, I am going to include all of these books in my Amazon storefront list, which I have linked in the description box below for you. So if you're interested in finding out a little bit more about any of these books, you can find it right there. And just a little tip for you. When you open up a book product description on the Amazon website, if you look at the actual picture of the book, there's a little tab that says look inside at the top of some of them. And if you click on that tab, it'll show you pictures from the inside of the book. And that's a really great way, if it's a book that you don't physically have in front of you, to kind of get an idea of what the reading level looks like and decide if it's right for your child before you buy it. I know that I do that all the time. All right, now without further ado, let's jump into the list of books. So first I'm going to share with you a list of book series that have multiple titles in each one that are on a variety of different topics. So basically anyone can find something that suits their child's interests. The first one is the Global Baby series. Global Baby, I believe, was the original book, but there's a whole series of them now that accompany it. And we all know that babies love looking at faces, especially of other babies. So this is an excellent one to introduce to your child from the earliest age. Along those same lines is the book Making Faces. Not only is this one really great because babies like looking at faces, but it also begins to kind of teach your child a little bit about what emotions look like on someone else's face. So it's a good starter book for social emotional intelligence learning. The next one is National Geographic's Little Kids First Board Book series. I personally love this series because the photographs on each page are large and beautiful and crystal clear, and the text is very simple and easy to follow along with. If I had to put an age range on it, I would say that out of all of the National Geographic series I'm about to recommend, this is the one that I would start with. Once your child has kind of graduated from this level of books and they're ready for a little bit more interaction, then I would recommend as the next level up the National Geographic Little Kids Look and Learn series. This one is definitely aimed at toddlers because it asks them to do things like point to pictures and match things and decide which things are different. This one is one of Kylie's personal favorites, and we've checked out, I think, all of the ones that are available at our local library, and now I'm looking to actually purchase some for our own. Moving on up in age levels, the next series from National Geographic that I really like is the Explore My World series. Again, big, colorful, gorgeous photographs on every page and text that's very easy to follow along with. It's just a little more scientific, so that's why I kind of feel it's a little more suitable for older toddlers and preschoolers. And finally, for your dedicated little budding scientists out there, the National Geographic Little Kids First Big Book of Blank, for example, Big Book of Dinosaurs, Big Book of Animals. They have a couple of them on a variety of different topics, but they really are pretty big books. They are a lot more detailed as far as the scientific information that's included in them. I don't think that the text is appropriate for a younger infant or toddler. definitely more for older toddler and preschool age group. That doesn't mean you can't read these books to your baby or toddler, just that they would probably be primarily interested in the pictures as opposed to any of the text that's on the pages. And there's nothing wrong with getting started early, reading it out loud to them anyway, and exposing them to as much language as possible. Next up is the Rookie Toddler series. This one I discovered at the library. I had never seen it prior to that, and Kylie loves these books. I think the primary draw is that it features children her age in the books, and they're doing things that she's familiar with in everyday life. Some of the titles also give her practice with things that she's interested in learning about, like colors and shapes and numbers and animals and tractors and vehicles and things like that. The Mrs. Pinochle's Alphabet series is also a very interesting one. In a Montessori environment, when children are learning letters, they actually learn the letter sound first, as opposed to learning the names of the letters. So you would say, this is A, as opposed to A. And I think at this point we've checked out most of these books from the library, and all but one of the pages in every book we've looked at so far has the correct phonic sound for each of the letter used in the examples. So for example, in the Mrs. Pinochle's Vegetable Alphabet book, I believe they use asparagus as the example, which is perfect because A for asparagus matches up for the phonic sound perfectly. I also really like this series because, again, they have it on a couple of different topics, but each of them is very beautifully illustrated and definitely true to life nonfiction. Another series that I stumbled across is the Hello World series. The only one that I've looked at so far is the book about dinosaurs. However, I know that they have a bunch on a variety of other topics, and I really liked this one because not only does it have a very interesting artistic style for the illustrations, it also struck me as very scientific, but in a manner that's very well suited for young kids to understand. Kylie really enjoyed the dinosaurs book, and I'm hoping that our library carries a couple of the other titles so that we can try some of the other ones too. The next one is one that I'm pretty sure most of you have probably come across before, but just in case you haven't, it's the First 100 series of books by Pretty Books. Personally, we own the First 100 Words, First 100 Numbers, and the First 100 Animals Lift a Flap book, and all three of them are Kylie's favorites that she has come back to time and again since she was a baby, and she still reads them today at almost 2.5. These books are filled with nothing but real life photographs, and some of them, like the Animals book, even have interactive lift a flaps. Another popular one that I just wanted to make sure that I mentioned is the Baby Touch and Feel series. What I love about this series is that each of the pages typically features one very well-defined photo and either one small word or phrase that goes with it. And because it is a touch and feel series, each of the pages also has a unique texture in the book for your baby to interact with. One of my toddler's current favorites is the Can You Say It Too series. This one has really fun illustrations and questions that get your toddler thinking. And of course, it is a lift a flap series, so she loves peeking behind each of the flaps and seeing what's there. Similar to the First 100 series are the DK My First series. What's great about this series is that the pictures are all realistic and, again, very simplistic, really aimed at things that babies and toddlers are interested in, like animals and construction vehicles, and also things that they see in their everyday life. The next series is actually not a series of books, more so than it is a series of books by a particular author. The books are all called Jane Foster's something, like Jane Foster's Colors or Jane Foster's 1, 2, 3, Jane Foster's Things That Go. She has a whole bunch of them on different topics. And what I love about these books is that the illustrations are kind of artistic in a way, but they are still for the most part true to real life, and they're very bold and high contrast. The very first book that we purchased when Kylie was a baby was Jane Foster's Colors, but we have discovered all of the other ones at the library, and she consistently asks to check them out every single time we go. Another author like this, who has a whole series of books on all kinds of different nonfiction topics that are very well written for young children, is the author Gail Gibbons. Now, these books are definitely for older toddlers and preschoolers. The topics available for this book series are so specific that this is kind of perfect for those moments when your child suddenly has an interest in bugs or tornadoes, and it has a lot of really great scientific information that your child would really benefit from in wanting to know more about that specific topic. Now, the My First Touch and Feel Sound Books series is really fun because not only is it a touch and feel book, but each of the touch and feel parts of it has a little sound button underneath. So when your child presses the button, it makes the appropriate sound for whatever the picture is. For example, a cow will make the mooing sound. These books include actual photographs of the things that the books are about, and I would say a very basic level of information about each of the topics. Now, here's a series that I would definitely recommend for babies. It's a series of three different books by author Tana Hoban, and they do not have words in them at all. They are strictly high contrast black and white pictures. The three books are called Black on White, White on Black, and Black and White. The pictures are just of everyday things that your baby might come into contact with, and they're complete silhouettes, either black on a white page or white on a black page. If I had to choose a book out of this list to start with for the youngest of babies, this would be my selection. The next series of books don't actually have a name for the series as far as I know. They're just called the Amicus Inkboard books. The books are pretty short in nature, all use realistic photographs, and the text on each page is very simple. If you have a child that is absolutely obsessed with dolphins, for example, then this would be the perfect series to go to for the animal or construction vehicle. I keep saying that over and over again, but that's typically the trend you see in children's books, is either animals or things that go and shapes and colors and numbers. And that's exactly what this series focuses on too. The last three series that I want to mention are all kind of related to each other because I believe they're from the same publisher. The first one is called the Baby's Love series. Now, right on these books is a little sticker that has an age recommendation, and the Baby's Love series says 0 months plus. And I would definitely agree with that because the books are very simplistic. However, each of the books includes a little lift the flap, which obviously a newborn baby is not going to be able to make use of, but you can certainly move the flaps for your baby and continue reading it to them that way. The next level up in this series from this publisher is the Chunky Lift a Flap series, and they're not any chunkier than the Baby's Love series. The main difference is that the text is a little bit longer. You have full sentences as opposed to a short phrase, and it asks questions to get your child thinking a little bit about what's behind the flap. And finally, the most advanced in this particular series of board books is the Lift a Flap surprise books, of which I've only found four actually. There could be others, I guess, but I did look and I only found four, one for each of the seasons of the year. The text on the pages in this series is a little bit more complicated, so definitely for older toddlers, and I think the sticker actually recommends for 18 months and up for this series. I want to make sure I also recommend a smaller series of books that I have purchased for Kylie and she loves, and we always keep them out on her bookshelf, and that is the Montessori series. There are just a couple of them. It's Montessori letterwork, Montessori numberwork, Montessori shapework, and Montessori mapwork. I really think this series is perfect for the Montessori at home parent who's wanting to introduce their child to letters and numbers and shapes and maps before their child has actually gone off to school. The books are purposefully tactile, meaning that, for example, in the Montessori letterwork book, each of the pages has a letter on it with a sandpaper texture for your child to trace with their finger, just like they would with the traditional sandpaper letters at school. So when your child is ready to start learning the phonic sounds of the different letters of the alphabet, this would be my go-to book to start with. For the remainder of this video, I'm gonna share with you individual titles that I have come across and read with Kylie, and they have proven to be favorites. Again, it bears repeating that this is not an exhaustive list. There are literally millions of books out there. These are just the couple that I have found and love and would recommend to you guys. So the first one is Open the Barn Door by Christopher Santoro. The illustrations in this book are really cute, but definitely lifelike, and there's really adorable little lift the flaps for the child to discover which animal is behind each part of the farm. Tooth by Leslie Patricelli, I hope I'm saying that right, was one of Kylie's favorites that we checked out from the library that we stumbled across completely by accident. She actually has a whole series of books just like this. I think Tubby is another one that we read that has to do with a bath time routine, but Tooth is about a baby that is growing in his first set of baby teeth and what happens when you start teething. So even though my toddler already has all of her teeth and probably doesn't recall the actual teething process, she does have a little sister who is starting the teething process and drooling all over the place, and she really identified with the storyline in this book and she really loves it. So it's definitely worth checking out some of the other ones that she has too, but both Tooth and Tubby were definitely hit favorites. Another really cute one is I Spy on the Farm by Edward Gibbs. The illustrations in this book are very realistic, but still illustrations. And this book is interactive in a way that I've never seen in a book before. It actually has a hole on each page for you literally to look through and try to guess what the animal is on the next page. Flip Flap Find, Counting 1, 2, 3 by the DK series of books is really fun because it counts from 1 to 10 using animals that all hatch from eggs. And there's a really big flap for your child to lift on each one to find out what hatches. is from each of the types of eggs. I think out of all the books that we've read that involve counting, this is probably the one that she had the most fun with, and she kept asking me to read it over and over again. Who is the Biggest by Peter Horacek is a really great book for introducing your toddler to the concept of bigger and smaller. The book does use animals as the examples in each case, which was probably the primary point of interest for my daughter because she loves animals. But even for a child who isn't interested in animals as much, I would still recommend this book because the examples are just so clear. Another counting book is called Counting on Birds by Kate Riggs. This one uses very realistic illustrations of birds and their nests, and it provides your child with a motivation to count, like they're counting things that actually happen in real life as opposed to just counting for counting's sake. For example, I think one of the pages includes counting the number of eggs in the nest. Here We Are, Notes for Living on Planet Earth by Oliver Jeffers is one of my favorite books on this list, and it's also one of my daughter's favorite books as well because she has probably asked me to read this book about 10,000 times since she's had it. It's almost like a guidebook for children about what it's like to live on planet Earth and to be a human. The illustrations are really cute and definitely realistic, and there's a feel-good message behind the storyline of this book that really helps to instill in your child this sense of the fact that we need to share our planet and all of the resources on it because we are all people and we are all here to stay. Bugs, Bugs, Bugs by Bob Barner is the next one on my list. Each of the pages introduces you to a different type of bug, some of the most common ones that you'll see in your backyard. And what I really like are the very ending pages because it shows all of the bugs together on one page, and it shows you what their actual size would be in comparison to one another in real life. For some reason, she also really enjoyed the chart that's at the end that asks different questions like, does this bug sting? And it gives a little yes or no for each of the bugs. She really enjoyed going through that chart and having me ask her the questions and her trying to remember whether or not the bug stung or if it flew or whatever the question was. Rosie Goes to Preschool is a book by Karen Katz, a very famous children's book author. I don't think all of her books would technically fall in line with a Montessori ideal. However, this particular book does because it's about a child that is going to preschool. And although I think it's interesting because it's probably a little bit different than what a child going to a Montessori preschool experiences, it still has a lot of the basics that are common to basically any preschool. The process of arriving to school and putting your things away, greeting your teacher, sitting with other children and playing or working, having lunch, going outside for recess, things like that. And even though my daughter does not go to preschool yet, we have talked about it, and this book really held her attention. And I think it's because toddlers can understand that this book is about them. It's about their age group and something that they experience, so they identify with it and it makes it more interesting to them. Have You Heard the Nesting Bird by Rita Gray is a beautifully illustrated book that introduces children to all of the different sounds that birds make. Personally, as the adult reading this book, I found it kind of fun to really get into character and try to imitate all of the different sounds as they were spelled out on the pages for my daughter to hear. And she definitely learned a lot about how a bird nests, which was perfect because if any of you guys follow along on our family vlogs, you know that we had a couple of birds this past spring that had decided to make a nest in the wreath on our front door. Plant the Tiny Seed by Christy Matheson is an interesting book. The aim is basically to teach your child about the process of a plant growing from a seed into a beautiful flower in a garden. But what's interesting is it involves a little bit of interaction on the child's part as you're reading. For example, it'll ask the child to cut across the flower stems to trim off the buds because the plants need trimming. So this one was a simple and easy to read book with her, and she really seemed to enjoy the interactive component of it. Next up is Deep Deep Sea by Fran Preston Gannon. I know I've probably said this about 1,000 times, but I do mean it. The illustrations in this book are beautiful, and for any child that has a specific interest in the different types of ocean creatures, this one is a really good one. It is a very simple and short book, but for some reason my toddler kept picking this one off the bookshelf time and again, so I thought it was worth mentioning in this list. Now, for those of you parents who are in the throes of potty training, Big Girl Panties by Fran Mnuchin is a fabulous book. There is also a boy version called Big Boy Underpants, and my toddler loved this book when we first started potty training. And I think what she really loved about the character is that the character was kind of funny and humorous and easy to identify with. She goes around around the house telling her stuffed animals and her little sibling, no, no, you can't wear panties. Only big girls can wear panties. And I think part of the excitement about this book was reading it with enthusiasm. Kylie thought this book was really funny, and I really think it helped to make her feel a little bit more comfortable with the whole idea of wearing underwear instead of diapers when we first started doing that. So out of all the potty training books out there, this one was definitely our favorite. Another good one for potty training that we also read as a bedtime book for some reason is called Everyone Poops by Taro Gomi. This is definitely a very interesting book if you've never read it before, but it is very straightforward about the fact that all animals on this planet, including humans, have to poop at some point after they've eaten. And I think it really helps children to feel more comfortable talking about this topic, because for some families and some cultures even, it's a little bit of a taboo subject, but it does introduce the topic in a very scientific way. And again, there is a child going to the bathroom in this book as well, so it really helped her to identify with the fact that pooping is normal. What is Baby Gorilla Doing by Christina Nippert Eng is a really cute book that basically just shows a baby gorilla doing different activities throughout his day. For any children that have a great interest in animals, especially baby animals, this is certainly a great book that I would recommend. It does include realistic photographs of the gorilla, and some of the things that the gorilla is doing are things that your toddler does as well. Another great counting book is Bedtime 1-2-3 by Eric Walters. The illustrations in this book are just beautiful, and it features a variety of different cute cuddly animals on every page who are also getting ready and tucking in for the night to go to sleep. It's definitely a short and simple, easy to read board book, and it's a great way to practice counting really easily in the context of something that your child is familiar with already, which is going to bed. The last counting book on my list is called One Rainy Day, a Counting Book by Shona Viswanath. And I don't think I've ever quite seen a style of illustration as like I have in this book. It's a very bold, beautiful type of illustration, almost kind of like a collage if I had to put a name to it. Each of the pages just counts different types of things that you would encounter on a rainy day, like umbrellas or muddy boots or hot cups of tea. The book does count from 1 to 11, which I think is kind of odd. I feel like it probably should have stopped at 10. But regardless, this is one that my toddler is really enjoying right now. It's actually on the shelf behind us. And for a child that is interested in counting, this is another great one to add to your list of books to read. The next two books are both by the same author, Kevin Hanks. The first one is called When Spring Comes. He does have books for each of the other seasons as well. And what I love about these books is that they are illustrated, but they are illustrated true to real life. And I thought it was a very simple and beautiful way to introduce my child to just kind of an appreciation for the different minutiae that you might otherwise overlook in nature as each of the seasons approaches. The other book is called Birds, and I really enjoyed this one because my toddler has recently become interested in asking me about what the different types of birds are that she sees outside, and this one really covers a lot of the most common ones that you would see. And finally, for any child that is in love with puppies and dogs, the book Heads and Tails by Carly Davidson is perfect for teaching your child about body parts on dogs. It includes very large photographs, very up close of the different parts of a dog, and I would say that this is definitely a very silly but fun book to read with your child. One last thing that I did want to mention in this video, because I get asked about it quite often, is the bookcase that you see behind me here. This bookcase was lovingly built by my husband for my daughter's first birthday. It is a front-facing bookcase, which is ideal for babies and toddlers because they can see the covers of the books, which really enables them to remember which books were their favorites and then go and actually pull them off of the shelves and put them back by themselves. You can purchase these types of bookcases online. I will leave links to a couple of them below for you guys to check out. But if you are interested in learning how my husband built the one that you see behind me, I actually do have a DIY tutorial on my blog, which I will also link below for you guys, where he actually shared the exact materials and steps along with pictures that he took to make this bookcase for her. So that's it for my list of children's book recommendations for a Montessori household. If there were any books on this list that sparked your interest and you want to learn a little bit more about them, again, I did include a link to my Amazon storefront below in the description box. If you click through to there, I do have a whole section entitled Books for Children, and every single one of the books in this video today is on that list. And of course, if you had any questions about the books that I shared with you, then please leave me a comment down below. If you liked today's video, then please be sure to give it a big thumbs up. And just in case you are new to my channel, I did want to let you know that this video is part of a larger series called Montessori at Home, which is aimed at providing practical tips and advice for busy parents like you and I for implementing Montessori philosophies at home with your children. So if that sounds like something that you're interested in learning more about, then you might consider subscribing to my channel so that you don't miss a new video, because I do upload a new one just like this one every single week. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.